بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. My dear respected viewers, we begin any this session any by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity for us any to continue with the answer any towards any the meaning of al-istiwa, as mentioned in the Quran, in a few verses in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in Surah Al-A'raf mentioned summa istawa ala al-arsh, and in another verse also Allah mentioned ar-Rahman on arsh istawa. So this is our third any session speaking any about the meaning any of istawa. Our first session and I was addressing any the question about the meaning any of Ar-Rahman Arsh Istawa, and then any we enter into the tafsir. And basically this any a request any from some any jama'ah to speak any about the tafsir any of this particular verse. So earlier what happened was I did a session any on the tafsir of Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi and Ibn Kathir, but there was issue any with the sound. So what happened any was, as I think some of you any saw any the video, that half any of the video there was no sound. So that is why any I intend any to do this again inshallah ta'ala, because listening any to something halfway is not any the same any as listening any fully. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah bless any this session and bless us any with the understanding. So what I did was I put the PowerPoint slides and so that easy any for us any to refer for the Arabic text, and you can also refer to the I put in the description and in the YouTube and likewise in Facebook. So yeah, any without any wasting any time, and we will enter into speaking about the tafsir of Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi. So Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi, yani in this particular verse anyway, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned fa'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim summa istawa 'ala al-'arsh. So as what I mentioned many a times, any there are people any who use any this particular verse any to establish that Allah is at a particular place, at a particular direction, and that is any on top any of the arsh. So we say this is against any decree of Ahlul Sunnah. None any of the scholars any of the Ahlul Sunnah any mentioned that Allah is binded any by place and space. Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Allah exists without a place and is not binded any by space and time. Taib. When we go back any to the books of tafsir, Al-Imam Qurtubi, yani he said, هَذِهِ مَسْأَلَةُ الْإِسْتِوَاءِ وَلِلْعُلَمَاءِ فِيهَا كَلَامٌ وَإِجْرَاءٌ. So he said that any the scholars has so many explanations on the meaning any of Al-Istiwa in this particular verse. Istawa ala al-arsh. So we have any this repetition any in the Quran, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rash, Istawa, Istawa ala al-arsh. So what is any the meaning any of Istawa? So he said, وَقَدْ بَيَّنَّا أَقْوَالَ الْعُلَمَاءِ فِيهَا. Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi and he said that we have explained the meaning fil kitabil al-asna fi sharhi asma'il husna wa sifatihi al-ulya, yani this particular book, and he said that I have explained the meaning any of istawa in this particular book. What is the name of the book? Al-asna fi sharhi asma'il husna wa sifatihi al-ulya wa dhakarna fiha hunaka 14 qawlan, and he said that we have mentioned 14 opinions on the meaning any of istawa. والأكثر من المتقدمين والمتأخرين أنه إذا وجب تنزيه الباري سبحانه عن الجهة والتحيز. So he said that most any of the متقدمين والمتأخرين, يعني the people, scholars any of the past and scholars any of the present, what any to say? They say that it is compulsory that we believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free عن الجهة والتحيز, is free from being binded by direction and space. So now any we have any these two terms. So let me explain. Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi any mentioned it is impossible that we ascribe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with jiha. What is any jiha? Any jiha in the Arabic language any meaning direction. Direction. So for example, above is a direction, below, right, left, in front, behind. This is called jihad to sit. Al-Imam Tahawi, for example, in his book, Aqidah Tahawiyah, and he's from Manus Salaf. Yani he said, Wallahu munazzahun anil jihati sit kasa'iril mubtada'at. That Allah yani is free. Allah yani is free yani from being any binded any by jihad to sit, yani the six any directions. So meaning, it is impossible to believe any that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is binded any by a direction, because any if you do so, then basically any we are saying that Allah any is limited any to a particular any direction, and there are serious any consequences any towards any disbelief. This is a dangerous ideology. You need to believe any that God any is limited, because any it brings any about the characteristic any of contingency, and Allah any is different any from contingent beings. So this is point number one. Al-Imam Qurtubi any mentioned al-jihah. Number two, yani he mentioned what tahayyuz. Tahayyuz, yani is binded any by space. Binded any by space. Take up space. We say this tahayyuz in Arabic language. So for example, my body take up the space here. I am occupying any this space. This is called tahayyuz. So can we imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, take up any a particular space? Again, yani, this is impossible any for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, wajib tanzihul bari from hada. It is compulsory any that we do not any associate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or ascribe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these characteristics, yani being binded any by space and direction. فَمِنْ ضَرُورَةِ ذَلِكَ وَلَوَاحِقِهِ اللَّازِمَةِ عَلَيْهِ عِنْدَ عَامَةِ الْعُلَمَاءِ الْمُتَقَدِّمِينَ وَقَادَتِهِمْ مِنَ الْمُتَأَخِّرِينَ تَنْزِيهُهُ تَبَارَكَ تَعَالَى عَنِ الْجِهَةِ. So again, and he mentioned that it is yani from the necessary belief yani in Islam amongst any the ulama of the past and ulama of the present, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should not any be ascribed by being any binded any by direction. عَنِ الْجِهَةِ فَلَيْسَ بِجِهَةٍ. Now yani he mentioned any clearly, Allah is not binded by al-jihah. So we cannot say that Allah any is above. This is any the phenomenon. Some Muslims any fell any into this tashbih when they were asked, or they themselves any asking any others, where is Allah? So their answer any is Allah any is above. No, this is wrong. We cannot any be saying any that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above any in a sense place. This is not permissible and this is wrong. This is against any the aqidah of Islam. Because the moment any we say that Allah any is above, meaning what we meant any is a direction, then any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is limited any to that particular any direction, and he is taking up any the space any that is above, then this is impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Al-Imam Qurtubi mentioned falaysa bi jihati fawq. Allah yani cannot any be ascribed any to the direction of above, fawq. عندهم لأنه يلزم من ذلك. So what happens any if a person any believes that Allah any is above any in terms any of place? He say يلزم من ذلك. Now it leads any to the conclusion, or it becomes any something that is necessary. متى اختص بجهة, if Allah any is ascribed any by a direction, أن يكون في مكان. So the moment any we say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is binded any by a particular any direction, meaning he is in a place. He is in a place. Yani the moment any you say something is in a particular direction, meaning any he is at this particular place. Yani from this any direction. Binded any by place and space. Tamam? So this is dalalatul iltizam. Dalalatul iltizam. Yani it is something any that comes out as a conclusion any necessarily. So he said, اِخْتَصَّ بِجِهَةٍ أَنْ يَكُونَ فِي مَكَانٍ أَوْ حَيِّزٍ. So it brings any about that thing that is binded any by direction, it is in a particular place or take up any space. Now, that is necessary. Any if we say something any is at this particular direction. If something any that is above me, meaning I am ascribing a place to that thing. If I say that something is in front of me, now I am again ascribing any to a place and space. So that is the same thing any when we say Allah any is above, and you are ascribing any place and space any to Allah, and that is impossible any for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yalzamu ala al makani wal hayyizi. This is important. He said that then any it brings any about that if we say that Allah is bounded by direction, then necessarily Allah is in a place and take up space. If that is the case, then also it leads to the necessity of al-haraka was-sukun lil-mutahayyiz. Yani it leads to the notion of movement and non-movement. Because something that take up space and in a place, it is also ascribed to whether it is at still or it is moving. And all and also he said watarayur. So that ascription also brings about the adaptation of change, that it can be changed, it can be moving, it can be at still. And all these things are the characteristics of contingent beings. So he said watarayur wal hudus. So it leads to ascribing that Allah in a place, take up space, and possible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be moving or not moving, to change from one place to another place, and also all these things brings about contingency. So believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bounded by direction, bounded by place and space, all these things brings about believing that Allah is similar to contingent beings, and this can lead to kufur to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'udhu billah min dalik, as will be explained by Sheikh Ibn Kathir. And after this we will look into what is mentioned by Ibn Kathir in his tafsir. Right. So this is the meaning of this the interpretation of istawa by Al Imam Al Qurtubi. So what we have understood from Al Imam Al Qurtubi, and likewise last week I spoke about the tafsir of Mawardi by Dawi, basically we are seeing a consistency in explanation that Allah cannot be ascribed to a place, space, direction, it cannot be ascribed to contingencies. So the interpretation of al-istawa, so many of the mufassirin mentioned the meaning of istawla Allah has power over the arash, not he's on the arash. And likewise so many of the ulama mentioned, we do not give a specific interpretation and we believe, but with the condition that Allah is not ascribed with all these contingent attributes of taking up space or being in a direction and so on and so forth. Taib, I hope it is clear inshallah. So now we will enter into the tafsir of Ibn Kathir. Tafsir of Ibn Kathir. So he said, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ فَلِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْمَقَامِ مَقَالَاتٌ كَثِيرَةٌ جِدًّا لَيْسَ هَذَا مَوْضِعُ بَسْطِهَا. The first thing Ibn Kathir mentioned, that there are a lot of interpretations pertaining to this particular verse. And he said that this is not the place anywhere I should speak about it lengthily, but I will just summarize he mentioned in the beginning. So he said innama naslaku fi hadha al-maqam madhhab as-salaf as-salih. Sheikh Ibn Kathir now he said that I will follow the methodology of the pious predecessors, the salaf as-salih. Who are the salaf as-salih? What is meant by the salaf as-salih are the scholars who live within the first 300 years of the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there is a famous methodology of these scholars, which is rampant amongst them, that they do not specify a particular interpretation to the word istawa. So they emphasize on the importance of believing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, believing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, summa istawa ala al-arsh, we recite summa istawa ala al-arsh. We believe in whatever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, with the condition without making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala similar to his creations, and not making resemblance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with other than him. So this is basically what he is going to mention. So he said that this is the methodology of the Salaf al-Saleh. Who are the Salaf al-Saleh? Some examples he said Malik wal Awza'i wa Sawri. These are Al-Imam Malik, Imam Al-Awza'i, Imam Sufyan Al-Thawri, Al-Lays bin Sa'an, Al-Masri, Wa-Shafi'i, Al-Imam Shafi'i, Ahmad bin Hanbal, Isaac bin Wahuya. All these are famous ulama. These are the great ulama within the blessed time of the first 300 years of the Hijrah. وَرَيْغِهِمْ مِنَا إِمَّةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ قَدِيمًا وَحَدِيثًا. So he said, what is the methodology? وَهُوَ إِمْرَاهُهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ مِنْ غَيْرِ تَكْيِيفٍ وَلَا تَشْبِيهٍ وَلَا تَعْتِيلٍ. So now we are going to speak about this sentence any that is mentioned any by Sheikh any Ibn Kathir. So we have to to understand. What did he say? He said, "Wahwa imraruha kama ja'at." Imraruha meaning when you look any at the Quran, when you recite any of this particular verse, yani we believe yani in everything that has been revealed. Point number one. As Muslims, we believe in everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed any in the Quran. Every verse, any from the beginning till the end. When comes any to this particular verse, any Sheikh Ibn Kathir any mentioned, we believe in the words any that were revealed as we recite them. Kama ja'at, as how any it was revealed. Min ghayri takyifin. So he said that without any giving a kaif, without giving any a how. Like, what does it mean? You see, in aqidah, this is any important. Foundations any in aqidah is that we believe that it is impossible any for human beings to understand the reality of the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes any to the essence any of Allah, no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who understood the reality any of his essence. Likewise, the attributes any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is not permissible for any Muslim to describe Allah the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not any permissible for a Muslim any to describe the reality of the attributes any of Allah. In terms of reality, nobody knows. So when we study aqidah, we are studying the rulings any of the essence any of Allah. So there's a difference. We are studying the ahkam of the third of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah laysa kamislihi shay, Allah is not like other things. These are ahkam. But when it comes to the reality of the essence any of Allah, nobody knows. Nobody knows. The human mind cannot understand. So here any Sheikh Ibn Kathir any mentioned that it is not any permissible any for anyone to put a kaif, meaning to describe the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in its reality. Because in reality, nobody knows any Allah except Allah. Nobody knows any of the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment any a person say Allah is a body, now khalas. Yani this is any astray. Allah yani is not a body. The moment any a person says Allah yani is above and take up space, this is takif. Takif. This is any describing any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with contingencies. You are describing the entity of Allah. You are giving a description any to the essence any of Allah, that you are saying that Allah is binded any by space, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani is a body, and so on and so forth. So he said that it is not any permissible any to describe any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason any why our ulama, even this our scholars any in books any of aqidah, as what any I mentioned, is that nobody any understand the reality any of the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody understand the reality of the attributes any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tamam. So he said, min ghayri takyifin wala tashbih. Tashbih yani is resemblance. Yani we cannot describe any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resembling any his creations. His creations, any for example, take up space. And we cannot be saying and Allah also take up space. His creations any are binded any by directions, and we cannot ascribe any direction any to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tamam. So nowadays any when people say Allah yani is on top any of the arash, Allah yani is binded any by direction, that he is any in a place, that he is above us, above any in terms any of taking up space and place, all these things any at tashbih. Yani we are resembling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with other than him. So this point number two. So Sheikh and Ibn Kathir now any is explaining any the methodology any of the Salaf any when it comes to the mutashabihat. Number one, min ghayri takyif. Tamam. Min ghayri takyif, without giving any a description on the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without any give, because as what we mentioned, the reality any of the essence of Allah, nobody is able any to understand the reality any of Allah, reality of the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody understand the reality of the attributes any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is not any permissible any for a person to give a description on the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the reality, on the attributes any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tamam? Number two, he speak about tashbih. It is not permissible any for a person to make Allah resemble any his makhluk. Tamam? So that is why the foundation, kullu ma khatara fi balik, fallahu khilafu dhalik. Kullu ma khatara fi balik. Everything that strikes in your mind about Allah, fallahu khilafu dhalik. Allah is not like that. So this, when we imagine that Allah is something, that is tashbih. that Allah is like something based on our own imagination, this is any tashbih. We have any to negate that. We have any to negate. Allah is not the same any as his makhluk. Laisa kamislihi shay. Nothing any is like any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala ta'til. Point number three, he said ta'til. Yani ta'til, any basically any is to reject. Muslims, any do not reject any of the Quran. Allah mentioned summa stawa ala al-arash. We say summa stawa ala al-arash. Amanna. We believe. So we cannot any be saying, no, actually, any this verse, any is not there. We have any to change any some any of the structure, any of the sentence and all these things. Now this is ta'til. And ta'til, any leads to kufr. Not believing verses any of the Quran in the Arabic any language that was revealed leads any to kufr. So as what I mentioned in the beginning, that we Muslims, we believe in the kitab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the book of Allah, the Quran. Meaning we believe that everything that was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a revelation any of the Quran, we believe any in everything any that was revealed. But here any we speak any about the meaning. So there is any a difference any between a verse any in the Quran and the meaning any behind any those, the meaning any behind any those verses. Taib. So Ibn Kathir any is one any of those who does not any specify specific any meaning. Different any from Al Imam Mawardi, for example, Al Imam Baydawi, so what we mentioned in last week. Yani they mentioned some many of the Mufassirin, yani they said that the meaning of istawa can be interpreted as istawla. Yani Allah yani overpower, yani his creations. Yani Allah has power yani over the arash, has power yani over the creations yani of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when our scholars yani give that kind of interpretation, that kind of interpretation and is an interpretation that is in accordance any with the greatness any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So istawla any do not speak any about how any the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. Istawla any speaks any about the greatness any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah created the arash as a sign of his greatness, not any as a place any for him to reside, because God any is not in need any of something. God any is not in need of something that he himself any created. That is impossible. How can Allah any created any the arash and he is dependent any on his own any creation, or worse any we say that he is in need any of that thing as a place any for him any to recite, all these any are impossibilities. وَظَاهِرْ المتبادر إِلَى أَذْهَانِ الْمُشَبِّهِينَ. Then Sheikh Ibn Kathir any mentioned any something any important. So when we are reading any Ibn Kathir any, we have to pay attention any to some of the things any that he mentioned any after this. Then we are able to understand what he meant earlier. So he said that normally some people mutabadar any ila adhanil mushabbihin, yani those any who imagine and making resemblance any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani to other of his creations. He said this is zahir mutabadar. Sometimes yani it is something that becomes preponderant yani on the imagination any of a person, that he read any this particular verse and suddenly any he thought that Allah yani is like any the creations any that Allah any reside any in a place and binded by space and jiha and so on and so forth. So he said that this is tashbih by believing any that Allah any is the same any as the makhluk. This is manfiyun anillah. Why la yashbahuhu shay'un min khalqihi? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not yani the same as any of his creation. So having any this imagination of resembling and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not yani permissible. Then yani he quote any that particular famous any verse, laisa kamislihi shay'un wa huwa sami'ul basir. Nothing any is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is all hearing, all seeing. Then he said balil amru kama qala al a'immah. Yani the meaning any as what any is mentioned any by the ulama, the imams, minhum Nu'aym bin Hammad al-Khuza'i, and this particular great any scholar, the Sheikh of Imam Bukhari, Sheikh Nu'aym bin Hammad al-Khuza'i. What did he say? He said qala man shabbaha Allah bi khalqihi kafara. Yani those any who give resemblance any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to other than his creation, for verily any he has done an act of apostasy. وَمَنْ جَحَدَ مَا وَصَفَ اللَّهُ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. Likewise, any even a person any reject an attribute or something that Allah ascribed any for himself, that is also any an act any of apostasy. So as a Muslim, we believe in whatever Allah any has revealed, and We believe that Allah is not any the same any as His creations. All these things any have to be negated any when it comes any to impossibilities or similarities any with the contingent beings. وَلَيْسَ فِيمَا وَصَفَ اللَّهُ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ وَلَا رَسُولُهُ تَشْبِيهُ. So there is none resemblance from what Allah has revealed and the Prophet ﷺ yani has revealed any to us that carry any meanings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resembles His creations. So from the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, yani, it is clear that he is emphasizing yani, the importance of rejecting resemblance yani, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rejecting giving a description on the essence yani, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is also yani rejected. And likewise, the importance yani of believing in what Allah has revealed, in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed. So from here, as what Al-Imam Mawardi yani mentioned, there are two opinions yani of the Mufassirin. The first yani opinion is like what we see here, the opinion of Sheikh yani Ibn Kathir, and as what he mentioned, this is many yani of the scholars yani of the Salaf. They do not any give any specific any meaning to istawa, but at the same time also, they warn any against giving any resemblance any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and giving any interpretation any that is against the foundations any of Tawheed, that is ascribing impossibilities any to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or describing the essence any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all these things any is not any permissible. Tamam? This is point number one. Number two, so many of the scholars any who interpret the meaning of istawa, like some any scholars, like Al-Imam Baydawi, any for example, and Imam Fakhruddin Razi, which inshallah, if we have time, the next time any we can cover any tafsir of Razi. They mention any that istawa can be interpreted any al-istawla. Again, here any we are speaking any about the greatness any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any interpretation any that is suitable for towards any the greatness any of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not any something which is any impossible any for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be any ascribed to. So alhamdulillah, this is basically some any the summarize, or we say that the in short terms any the explanation any of this tafsir. And in reality, it is not any difficult any to understand this tafsir any of the ulama. So what is any important also as an advice that we get any from our mashayikh alhamdulillah, is that whenever any we have queries any on some any of the meanings any of the Quran, it is important any that we go back any to the books any of tafsir. Last week, this is what any we covered, the tafsir of Baydawi and Mawardi. As what any I summarized any earlier, the meaning of istawla. Likewise, what you call it, taking any the meaning of the pious any predecessors, any believing any in the verse, and not any ascribing any meaning to it generally, but at the same time, any. Understanding any of the conditions that Allah yani cannot any be ascribed any with the contingency. Wallahu a'lam any bisawab. I will stop here any inshallah, and hopefully any we can continue yani with the next parts any of the tafsir. We can cover any more any of this tafsir, and I hope any that we benefit any from this inshallah ta'ala. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.